Hello YouTube. I think it's recording. It's definitely recording. If it isn't recording, then this is for nothing, but don't worry about it. One lost video out of like 500, 600. It's gonna happen eventually, isn't it? Anyway, I'm playing Darkest Dungeon. This is Darkest Dungeonbeards, and I'm the Scoundrel M, and I haven't put the volume on yet, which is why everything's so bloody quiet. There we go. Are the sound levels good for everybody? Does everybody find me at an appropriate level? Yeah, it's all good, isn't it? Let's start playing, shall we? Let's get in here, do the campaign. I am the Scoundrel, as I've already said. I'm in the hamlet, and it's week 61. A red question mark on a hero's portrait indicates they are unavailable for the week. I did know that. Didn't need to read it out with quite so much force, but I did. And here we are. It's the way things have gone. Ooh, hello, what's this? Infernal foe.
I was lord of this place before the crows and rats made it their domain.
Eat the rich, or as Lemmy would have said it,
eat the rich!
Most curious of all, however, is the absence of any evidence in the crypt itself. Nevertheless, the chest was found open, its contents conspicuously missing. Idle grave robbers gain one resolve level. Okay, well, that means we don't take any grave robbers out then. Right, Grawl Seville, Finley, you sit back and just suck up the levels. Ah, oh, and did I say Finley and Grawl Seville? I did, didn't I? I thought I'd said something else. But I said the right names.
The right words were used.
So, let's have a look in the stagecoach, see what the state of play is. Have we seen all these people? Yigu, Petromol, Azor, Villihardane, Mashel, and Norman. Petromol sounds like some kind of evil corporation.
Welcome to the Petromol Corporation. We are professional destroyers of the environment, and we love nothing more than trafficking babies for... Well, just think evil, and you'll get it. You'll get there eventually. I mean, you'll be well within the ballpark. I mean, sure, you know, we do all bad stuff, but that's probably the worst thing we do. And we get paid handsomely for it, which is why we do it, because, you know, we're not evil people. We just want money. And evil people have money. And the best way to stop them using it for evil is by taking it off of them and doing the evil acts yourself. And then they are spared nothing. I'm sure my logic's breaking down somewhere. Anyway, let's get back to business. We don't have any business at the stagecoach. Our roster here is full. Let's go down to the embark screen and see what enticing dungeons are on offer. We could get a tough ring, which is apparently very rare. For a medium dungeon. Short. Hang on. I'm doing this arse about face. Let's get down here and have a look at who's sane and who's not. So we've got the same ones at the bottom this time. Now Sinead may be as solid as a rock mentally, but she's too high level to go in any real sensible parties, so we'll just leave her there for now. Duval, who the fuck is he? That's the question we need to ask ourselves. Where has Duval come from? Why is he in my roster? And what's going on? All valid questions. The JC experience seems ready to go, but if I remember rightly, he's got some debilitating issues. Yes, spotted fever and the aug, or the agui, or the agui. I don't know. I'm open to interpretation on that one. Folio, of course, also got some problems. We got some medical issues. Seems to be the big thing at the moment. Sanity, not too huge a deal. I mean, look at this. We have to go fairly high up the tree before we've got anybody with notable conditions. And you know, Super Chase is already in treatment. We don't have to worry about him. Maybe. Let's have a look at the hospital, see who we can cure. Let's heal up some of these atrocious maladies. Medical ward. We've got two slots. That's good. Can we upgrade? Get it cheaper? Patient cells. Number of treatment ward slots. Increases the chance of curing extra disease. Ooh, I like the sound of that. Let's have that.
The front line of this war is not dungeon.
Okay, now the war against disease is really underway. Look at this. We've got some serious advancement here. What's this next one? Increases chance of curing extra diseases. Medical devices level 4. Oh, we can't see what that does. Okay. Right, so let's get two of our peeps. I've got 32 grand here. We're all doing well. Let's get two of our peeps, pop them in treatment, and see if we can get rid of some of their ailments and maladies. What have you got? Show us who's our top tier crew we want to get sorted out. Well, Sinead. She's
only lethargic and not in any immediate danger of assignment to duty, so we'll have a look at JC Experience, who's much more likely to get out there. He's got a pretty bad collection of stuff, so I'm going to put him in. We're going to go to cure the Aug, and hopefully he'll get some Blight Resist taken away as well when that Spotted Fever gets cured. Here it goes, JC Experience. 825 gold. Still expensive, but more reasonable than it was before. Okay, who's next? Folio, you've been a long-term ill person, haven't you? I mean, you've had experience with many different diseases. Rabies and vampiric spirits, probably. You're not so fast. You've gone through the hellish trial of months of diarrhea. You had the runs, the trots, the squits, the insert nationality revenge. I can't remember the name of it now. There's that one. There's loads of like euphemisms for having diarrhea for like places with notoriously different food. And when I say different food, I mean food that you can't necessarily handle easily. Or, you know, just badly prepared, bacterially riven food. Riven? That's not the right word. That means torn apart or something. I mean, rife? Nah. Infested. Anyway, whatever. Let's stop clutching for words of infection. Let's have a little look at what we've got to cure. So, Folio is a tempting target. However, he's not a Namey, so we need to look back up the tree and see who among our Nameys most requires some medical treatment. Fuzzy Logic here has got scurvy, syphilis, and vertigo. Quite the collection. He's also pretty nutty with it. Behemoth, what's wrong with you? Bulimic. I mean, you know, I know it's a cliche that those kind of issues don't get treated seriously, but to be honest, mate, I mean, look at you, turning into a monster. You're probably eating human flesh anyway. It's probably a benefit to get some of that out of you. Tally boys, oh my beloved Tally boys. He's rabid, which is a classically annoying illness. However, he's not a Namey, and I can't treat him with the same level, much as he is my little golden boy. Finley Do, what about you? Only tetanus? I'm sorry, that's not a long enough list of ailments. We can't treat you now. Kiezu, hysterical blindness and lethargy. Quite the interesting combo. I mean, you would suspect that the lethargy would go somewhat towards countering entering a hysterical state. But maybe it doesn't. Maybe that's not true. Maybe I'm just thinking wrongly about lethargy and hysteria. Singospel, what's wrong with you? You're hysterically blind as well, but, you know, one ill... And you, together, you two combine to make a Kiezu. But right now, you don't have the need, the demonstrable need. Rue, you're not named after anybody, nor's Ghoul. Okay, so really, we're looking at curing Kiezu, Fuzzy Logic, or... Was that it? Was that just Kiezu or Fuzzy Logic who really were worthy of curing? And I think the clear winner, of course, is Fuzzy Logic, because look at this poor bastard. Scurvy, syphilis, and vertigo. Limes, antibiotics, and avoiding ladders and high places. I don't know. Vertigo's not... That's not vertigo, is it? I'm confusing problem with heights with dizziness. I think. I don't know. I'm not a you know, medical professional. So don't take my word on it. Okay, what are we going to cure? Well, oh my God, bleed resist and move resist down. Wow, he gets moved around. He can't even plant his feet. I imagine the small breeze would move him around. Let's go for syphilis now and hope for multiple heals. 1,100? Oh, the money I invest in the health of my party. Good lord. Let's unequip all trinkets while I think about it. No, you haven't died again. Don't worry, Super Shosi. You're still alive. You're just, there, Super Shosi. I don't think we did get a viewer called Duval. I'm pretty sure he came out of the, loving the new hairstyle. Oh, this is just... I just haven't got it tied back. There you go. Where was I? Talking about... Right, we've cured all the diseases. Everybody who's gonna get treated is getting treated. Let's go to the embark screen and see what we have on offer in the way of adventure. Book of Constitution for a medium apprentice dungeon. Oh, no. Again, I've done the same thing again. Let's sort by level actually, and have a look and see what we can do. Well, we can't really put together a whole party of level 4s, but supplemented with the level 3, we can put forward a reasonable force with a healer.
which is good. Not just any healer. Tally boys. Tally boys, the heels are crawling. Like tentacles, they crawl forth from your hand. Ah, oh, tally boys. I'm tempted to take level 4s onto a one of these dungeons here. This one's only medium level.
A necromancer is performing unspeakable rituals in the shattered halls of your ancestral home. It must be stopped.
Could do that.
The beastmen spill forth from 1,000 gaping holes. Pick one and search its extents.
Well, when you put it like that, who couldn't resist searching a gaping hole? What have we got here? No, I'm looking at the higher ones. These are bosses, right?
Intriguing. I don't believe I fought a boss for a while. It might be worth my time seeing what they're like, although it could lead to a full namey party wipe.
But curiosity is a driving force. They're both medium dungeons, they're both veteran. One is to kill the necromancer, and one is to kill another Brigand 12-pounder. Well, we've seen the Brigand 12-pounder, but we haven't seen the necromancer. Also, this one's currently at level 4, and this one's currently level 5, which means I'm assuming I've done more wield, meaning the wield's probably going to be a little bit harder. Logic that I've plucked out of the air, of course, but logic of a kind. What have we got going for us? You know what, I'm tempted to find out what this necromancer is all about, you know? What am I going to get for it? A tough ring. Alright, whatever. Let's see if we can put this party together.
Tally boys, sing gospel bass on Mars.
And who can fill the slot for the level 3s? Are we going to take a namey? Interesting. No namies in the level 3 tier. Yet two of them have had names assigned. Interesting. Oh no, Folio never got a name assigned, did he? He's still got his own name. Mind you, so has Tally Boys. Well, we can't go lower than level 3. That would be absolute insanity. We could take two lepers, but lepers are pretty shit in position 3. What about you, Base? Where do you like to stand? I always thought it would be front two rows. And he's not faring much better. Okay. We're going to take a level 3. And I'm thinking a necromancer sounds like it's going to do a lot of mind hurt. So we'll take a Folio. We're going to take the Jester. He's going to go... And everyone will feel better about themselves. Well, actually, no. Actually, is it better to take Mr. Inferior, who has a party-wide sanity heal, whereas Folio, who does ultimately heal more stress in one go, can only target one at a time. Oh boy. Deep questions. Do I even have that buff skill? It's Cry Havoc, is it? Yeah, it must be Cry Havoc. He doesn't even have Cry Havoc right now. And I'm loath to start dishing cash out to scrubby no-name... No, we're taking Folio. Folio is the one. Okay, back we go. Let's have a little peek at the guild and see if any of our guys can be upgraded. Oh, not the right mouse, the left mouse. Drag it over there. Right, so... Tally boys, tell us more about yourself. What can you do? Well, I can heal. I can hex. And I can do a few other bits and bobs. We've got a lot of money. I think it's worth putting some cash into him. We use this a lot. I've used that occasionally, so it might be worth...
Darn it.
Vulnerability Hex is not so massive at the moment because we don't have anyone who benefits from marked enemies. So Weakening Curse might be good. Remove damage from the enemy. And Hands from the Abyss is good for stunning.
What should I pick? Maybe I'll go for the Abyssal Artillery.
Yep, I'm gonna do it. Right, now, Sing Gospel. Oh, God, done it again. There we go, Sing Gospel. What can we do with you? Well, Smite seems like an obvious candidate. Battle Heal's good, but it's small change in the healing world. Do we really want it?
Holy Lance requires being right at the back. However, it's good for a shuffled Crusader. What else we got? Zealous Accusation, Stunning Blow, and Bulwark of Faith. Plus 6 Torch and 25 Protection to Self. I'm guessing the Necromancer is going to be unholy. It might be Eldritch. I'm not sure on the distinction between Eldritch and Unholy, but I'm going to go that it might be Unholy. So we're going to invest in that. And base, show me what you can do. Let's have a little look. Only some stuff. You know, we've had good results with you so far with the skills you have. Let's not start mucking around. And Folio! Folio, Folio, wherefore art thou Folio? Well, we certainly need to invest in sanity. That's an important thing. Don't overlook it. And seeing as you've been with us so long, you've suffered terrible diarrhea, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to take pity and I'm going to put you not quite in the same basket as Tally Boys. Somebody can still swoop in and steal your name, Folio. Don't get me wrong. I'm a big fan of your work. You've done very well for me. But if somebody wants to take you and make them your own, or their own, rather, then that's going to happen. You're not protected. Not like Tally Boys. Tally Boys is forever. You're for now. Anyway, let's level him up a bit. I'm guessing that bleeds are not going to be a big thing. I think we're going to go for Finale is too big. It's got that horrible debuff self thing going on. Excuse me. Actually, Battle Ballad. Clear option. If you're going to be a stand back healer, well, I say healer, you know, more of a therapist, you really need the buff skill as well. That's good. I think we will take Slice Off for when we do come across some bleeders. Right, so I think that's everybody leveled up. Let's check everybody's equipment. How do I get out of here? My brain stopped working. There we go. The blacksmith. Tally boys, what are you wearing? Not good enough, mate. Put on the new dogs. New dogs? Togs? Holy shit, we are spending some bank. Does this affect his... Does this only affect his attacks, or does this affect, you know, all of his spells as well? Interesting. Holy shit, we are going to spend some big money here. We're doing it. We're going to fight a boss. This is no time to be scrimping and saving and being stingy. This is the time to fucking spend. Right, 7 grand for a medium dungeon. It seems like it might not be enough. But let's see where it gets us. We're taking a party in that I have a medium level of confidence in. So hopefully we'll actually find a little bit of success here. We won't, maybe won't kill the Necromancer, but we'll get some treasure, right? Treasure's all good. That's all we really need. So let's dish out the trinkets. Where is Junior's head? That has to go with every healer we ever take, because plus 30% healing skills, it's just great. It's just great. Now, do we have any other items that will up his healing skills? Come on. Tell me all about your healing skills. Holy shit, what's wrong with his... he's got a disease. What have you got? Show me your disease. Bloody rabies. Always rabies with these hideous debuffs. Anyway, trinkets, that's what we were doing. You know what? I might take this crucifix. Anyone in chat? Is the Necromancer unholy or Eldritch? Am I wasting my time taking this with anybody, or, you know, what should I take? Give me some trinket help, please. Let's go for that. Okay, now obviously
I'm going to go for the Jester's Dice, because I love them. I love them. I think they're very, very appropriate for any Jester. There we go. And there's no downside. That's a big thing. Jesus, still got minus six. Oh, okay, rabies as well, right? Yep. Yep. This could be problematic. What else to give you? You know, we're not asking you to attack a lot, so maybe I'll just give you this. Boom. Boom. That's what I'm thinking. Okay. Up to the leper specialty stuff. I think we'll go for... not that one. That one. And that one. Lovely. Lovely. And for you, we're going to ignore the Knight's Crest. Because... okay, if it's unholy, we won't go with the Ethereal Crucifix. We're going to go with... plus 2 speed, plus 8 dodge. That seems pretty nice. But we need something to sort this accuracy issue out. Have you got rabies as well? Oh no, hysterical blindness. Minus 20 accuracy if stress above 70. Oh, minus 5 from a quirk. Oh, it's the bloody yips! We're going to have to get... we're going to have to do some no-torch runs to seriously, like, hack back on some of these problems these guys have got. We're really getting some issues. You guess he'll summon skeletons. I've got no doubt about that. I reckon we're going to be getting boned, so to speak. Boned in a bad way. So, maybe I will give him extra 10 hit points. There's got to be something better, though. And you know what there is. Extra damage. And... see, that takes him to negative speed. I don't think that's very good. You know what? You're going to be tanking. Let's give him that. Let's see how it goes. Okay. Onward to the provision screen. What do we get now? We need... oh, well, I want 3 shovels, 2 keys. Probably not going to be enough. Let's take 3 just in case. We're going to need a few of these. And some holy waters. That should... that's not too bad, right? Take some of these just in case. May as well take all the food. I think we're good. Okay, I'm off. Here we go. And it only took me 27 minutes. I entertained
a delegation of experts from overseas, eager to plumb the depths of their knowledge and share with them certain techniques and alchemical processes I had found to yield wondrous and terrifying results. Having learned all I could from my visiting guests, I murdered them as they slept.
Oh, lovely. Nice guy.
A devil walks these halls. Only the mad or the desperate go in search of him.
Okay, let's go find the necromancer. Now, I suspect he'll be here, but he could end up down here. It's a significant backtrack to get from one to the other. You know what? We're going to go straight for... which is less backtracking? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then 1, 2, 3. 3, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3. It's similar. This one's got more backtracking. You know what? Screw it. We're going to go there first. Here we go. What are we going to get from this? This gives us a buff, doesn't it? So, single... have a holy water buff. Yay! What does that do? Plus 30 damage until camp. Nice. He's got some serious plussing to his damage. I reckon we're going to get trapped down here. He's in the room furthest. Hello, Orosco 88.
Back to the pit.
The top one. Okay, we're going to go for the top one. You know what? My face is obscuring part of that map. So I'm going to say goodbye. Facially. Just facially. Not verbally. You'll still hear me. But I'm going to turn the webcam off. And if you don't like it, I'll say so and maybe I'll turn it back on. Bye-bye! And hello! This is Disembodied Me! Ooh, exciting, no? Right, let's carry on. We've got an obstacle. Let's just clear it out of the way. Why bother?
Bent on preventing passage.
I mean, why bother not? What have we got for ourselves here? Anything? nothing. But, as we progress, there are two battles ahead. Let's get them. Do I want to go here and get whatever's in these curios? You know what? Focus on the prize. We know where the necromancer's going to be, so let's... What are you doing? Don't... Tally boys, please don't do this to me. Don't be stealing.
Packs laden with loot.
All right, whatever, Tally boys. You're just curious. I can get behind that. I don't mind. All right, here comes a battle. To torch or not to torch? That is the question. You know what? I just want to fight the bastard. I don't want to get fat loot from this necessarily. I just want to get through and kill them all. Right, where to begin? Well, we already have some sanity issues to deal with. Unfortunately, I haven't got the right skills lined up. Oh dear. Can these things bleed? Not in a month of Mondays. In that case, we'll just do some sanity restoration here. Okay, who goes next?
Reeling.
I don't want to be too disparaging, because you're probably already quite self-conscious about these dibbly little wings on your back, but your crits are shit. 2 hit points. Are you really serious? That's absolutely pathetic. Okay, how much dodge have they got? Dodge 16. Not anymore. Now you have no dodge. We'll go for a straight up smite here, I think.
Executed with impunity. Was smitten.
Which is probably not the right conjugation of that, but never mind. Who really cares? Have you seen the base on Mars's chopper?
Another
it's very big.
Cleansed from our lands.
Okay, well, so far so good. That didn't really give us any trouble. Base. Give us a chance. Oh, come on, base. That could have gone well. We could have put some herbs in there and you would have got some kind of buff, but no. You got to be a... A bone commander. Interesting. We have not fought a bone commander previously. Let's see how we fare. This could be trouble. Oh, I didn't swap the skills out. Shite. Oh, okay. Can't do it mid-battle. Oh, well, next time we're going to get that one in, and things are going to go our way. Do-diddle-doo-doo-doo. Do-diddle-doo-doo-doo-doo. In a moment, Folio's actually taking up space and being a bit of a pain in the bum.
Ooh, base.
No. Good dodging. Good dodging. Right. None of us can hit the back row, I realise now. We have a pretty pathetic back row penetration, so we have to get rid of this guy as fast as humanly possible. Ah, but wait, scoundrel, you speak too soon. Let us... Shit. Okay. I spoke not too soon, but wisely, and in good time. Oh, sin gospel. I say... If you can do more of that, I think you might be getting my knickers off in lickety-split time.
How quickly the time turns.
The crits are worrying in that they seem to be affecting the sanity damage, not the damage. Okay, let's try this again. Demon's pull.
Well struck.
Woohoo! You, as they say in the industry, are fucked.
Destroyed.
Destroyed indeed. Oof. Uh-oh. It's alright, though. He's not the most useful person at the moment, so we can not worry too much. Okay. Clear all corpses. Not very much point. It's not him we're kicking back, so let's just actually go for a whack. Here it comes. 9 damage. I mean, it's not what Single was doing last round, but it's okay. We can live with that. Now, what's his dodge? 9, 6. You know what? I'm going to go for one of these, and I'm going to completely obliterate his dodge. Boom! No dodge. Looks like you're going to get hit a bit more, doesn't it? He looks awfully rotund for a skeleton, doesn't he? He must be rattling around in that.
Oh
my god.
For the slightest.
I think it's time for some healing. Ah, the healer's stunned.
Prodigious size
base,
alone does not dissuade.
Take it back.
The
there's nothing
blade.
Paltry about your damage dealing. It's perfectly acceptable. Right. Heal wants to... You know, this is good. Can't hit the back row. Let's buff a bit. Get ourselves back on top. More importantly, let's get our healer back online. Oh, base, this is looking pretty nasty. What have we got going on here? Okay. There's really nothing to do. Ah, good. Tally Boys is unstunned. Hopefully, we'll be able to get some healing for Bass before he, pops his clogs. May as well do a purge. Here it comes. Let's get this quarrel guy up where we can kill him. Should have thought of that before, actually. Here it comes, Bass. Sweet, sweet healing. Ow. Bleeding? That's not what I came for. Okay. Yes, single. Not single, sorry. Sing gospel. That old mistake rears its head again. Holy shit. 21 damage. Ooh, just one shy of what was needed. Let's bandage and maybe go for a straight up chop.
Press this advantage.
Chippy chip chop.
Give them no quarter.
Oh, a key. Oh, I probably brought too many with me, didn't I? What an idiot. Here we go. What's in the ornate locked sarcophagus?
Wait,
a debuff stone. Has anyone got a slot? No. This doesn't look like it's worth a lot of money, but however, it's probably worth more than jade. So goodbye, jade. Hello, trinket. Should we eat some food? I mean, it might actually make sense to camp, apart from the fact that he's got that 30% damage boost, which is pretty good considering the trinkets he's also carrying. Let's resort to food. Food is probably a better solution right now. We've got two stacks. We're well within range of the enemy, so... There we go. Everyone's looking fairly good. Not great, but fairly good. That's it. Resist. Refuse. Resist. Down, 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 down. That's a very bad rendition of Sepultura, but ah! I forgot to change the skills, but this time, this skill is worth something. So, what do? Do we slice off? Let's slice off the back row. Here we go, Gunboy. Oh, boy! I don't know what that little outburst was. I just went, oh, boy! It means nothing at all, but... I said it, so I should really just stand by it, really.
Body and brain.
Body and brain, which is, I would like to point out, part of your body. So, you know, a dizzying blow to the body. We could use the herbs to remove this debuff. Or we could just go nuts and kill him. I think I'll go nuts and kill this guy, kill this guy, kill this guy. I think I'll go nuts and kill this guy. 6 hit points, taking 4 damage. I can do 2 hit points, then he's no threat whatsoever. However, if I pull him... Yeah, let's pull him. We'll clear the corpses. Dead next round, aren't you? Kaboom. I think we're out of this one. I think we're out of the woods. Do a sanity heal on single? I think we need to keep on top of it. I can hit this guy though. Ah, sod it, let's just get rid of him.
Continue the onslaught. Destroy them.
Heal our leper. Lovely damage, Tally Boys. Although at level 4, I'd expect something a bit more from you. Don't get slack now. Keep it tight. Keep it tight. Make it twing like a drum. Twing? Twang like a drum. Not twang. Bong like a drum. Okay, do we keep the bleeds? What do I get if I get rid of the bleeds? Only that. Oh, sorry, only that. And that is all good, but... it's a debuff to yourself. And this one... you know what? We got our buffs. Just keep the bleeds for an emergency. It does make us very very good for this position. Okay. I don't know if Sing Gospel's actually watching. Did that pop up on Steam saying what he was playing? Maybe he's utterly unaware he's even involved in this combat. And when finale would have been useful, it is robbed from me by stupidity. Okay, this could be bad. Let's see if we can get into a good lineup. Right, you first. You, get back into position now. Oh, but that puts Tally Boys in a bad way. Go back one position, put a tank in the front row. That's what we need, really.
Exposed to a killing blow.
Mamma mia. That's it. The tank takes it like a champ. Tank champion. Right, do we want to juggle their lineup as best we can, or no, we've got to go for the heal. We can't have Tully Boys popping his clogs, buying the farm, kicking the bucket, or indeed passing on to the other side. Okay. Ooh la la, are you unholy? You are indeed unholy. Well, motherfucker, it's time to feel the pain. Here it comes. Are you ready? Bend over! Look at that, 47 points of damage. Oh my god, we should put him in the back row all the time. What have we been doing all this time? You. Oh, look at you, you stabby little bastard. Didgeridodging like some kind of... Well, I don't know, just really, really, really bad. Okay, here it comes. What are we going to do? What are we going to do? We are going to heal Sin Gospel. Ooh. Tally boys. Come on. You know how I feel about this shit. Stop it. Well, I think it's definitely a good idea to take this guy out. So, Popper the Clogger. 26 points of damage. It's not as good as the first one, but that first one was a rare old beast. What to do next? What to do next? Probably batter him round the head as quick as you can. That was meant to be some kind of little sung lyric there, but really, it didn't work, did it? It just became a very weirdly pronounced string of words. Everybody buffed now! 11 points of damage, that's not good. I do not like it. I do not like it at all. However, we have a healer. We have a healer, my friend. And he'll keep on healing till the end. Oh, I'm particularly out of tune tonight. Mind you, attempting to match the vocal range of Freddie Mercury is perhaps not the best place to sort of, you know, try out your vocal chops. 10. Not good. He needs to be in the front row, really. Ooh, 28. I am positively tumescent. Okay, what next? Sin Gospel. We should really use bandages, shouldn't we? I keep forgetting to use them. Come on, Sin Gospel, show me the damage. Oh, Sin Gospel, that is disappointing. But that was not. Base on Mars, your dodging is exquisite. What to do? Well, let's go for a chop.
Their formation is broken.
Critical!
Maintain the offensive.
Nice. Remind not enough room in the inventory, but who gives a shit about Citrine?
Killer.
Okay. No. We'll have you open it, please. Thank you very much. And it's unlocked, so let's give it a crack. What do we got? Emeralds. Good. Gold. Good. And a torch. Why not? We'll just use one. Take that one. Now, let's have a quick think. Now, after that impressive display, I'm going to start the next battle like this, because damn, son. Damn! Do we keep that 30% buff, which obviously was hot shit, or do we go for a camp and lose that but potentially gain some other buffs? I don't even know what these people's camping skills are. We can find out though, can't we? Look, look. Okay, they're all stress removal spells. Don't like that. How about you? No, don't want any of them. How about you? What do you got?
Every rose has its thorn.
No, we are not camping. We are holding on to this 30% damage buff forever.
The way is lit. The path is clear. We require
hopefully only one more room before the... Oh, dodged. I like it a lot, based on Mars. Congratulations. Uh-oh. What do we have here? A trap lock mechanism, you dingus. 2 damage per round for 3 rounds. You got a bandage, but I'm going to keep it for the battle, just in case. What do you mean you wonder how it works? It's a fucking torch sconce. You put a torch in it, you set it on fire. It's a very basic mechanism.
The match is struck. A blazing star is born.
Oh, you can use the torch from the loot window. I had literally no idea. No, no, no scout before we go in. You know what? Let's use that bandage. We may as well. We've got 2 more left. We should be alright. We're going to eat to heal everybody up. Hopefully we won't incur any hunger. Let's move on. What do we got?
Show me the necromancer.
Opu.
Gnawing well, hunger sets in, turning the body against itself.
I would call that an issue.
Weakening the mind.
Here we go. Necromancer.
Towering,
here we go.
Fierce, terrible, nightmare made material.
Okay, the clawing dead. Cool. Okay, and he's unholy. And Eldritch. Shit, we could have got... Oh, we should have taken that cross. Should have taken that bloody cross. Can he bleed? Can he bleed? He can bloody well bleed. So, Folio, if you wouldn't mind, please apply your scythe, or sickle, roar accurately, liberally. Here it comes. Oh, he resisted. How dirty. How bloody dirty. He's got 9 dodge, but I would say not anymore. Bye-bye dodge skill, and hello, big damage. Here it comes. Base on Mars has got a big old slice of damage ready for you here. It's good, but it's not super. What the fuck is this? Where's the Holy Lance? Holy War doesn't give him a Holy Lance? What? Oh, he can only target the back 2 rows. Shit. This is a problem right now. Summon another skeleton, and next round, your ass is toast. Or were I to want to rhyme, I could say grass. Na 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 na. Oh boy, everyone's getting tested by the look of it. Okay, now you have made a foolish error. You have placed yourself in perfect range of my crusader, and his damage is big. Boy, is it big. Reapply the hex to keep his damage down, or give him a little bit of extra damage straight up. We don't want to pull him forward, because that's going to take him out of the sweet spot. So... Oh, hey, this does plus 30% versus Eldritch. Eldritch. How long does it last for? Okay, we're going to try this out, see how it goes. Oh, 18! I love you, Teleboys. Could have dodged that. That would have put extra cherries on your cake, but never mind. What to do? Now, we don't really want to push him back, so we want him to get that fat damage. So, we'll just give him a little tickle. And here we go, Holy Lance. Good night, sweet necromancer. Good night. By the way, the hole on your hood makes you look like you have a butthole on your face. Ah, oh, yeah, 30 points of damage. Okay, and still in range for the bleeds. Oh dear, things are not looking good for you, are they? 8 damage per round. If you wouldn't mind, sir, would you, suck on that, I believe is the phrase. Yeah, you can try attacking my crusader, but he's a dangerous creature. Here it comes.
Precision and power.
What a delight. What a pleasure. Here it comes, another big fat one. It's alright. Not quite as girthy, but certainly very nearly as long. Okay, now we need to start thinking about getting rid of some of these scrub lords. So I'm going to do me a purge knockback. You know what? I think we're getting that second guy anyway. Let's do it. Smackaroo!
Surges as the enemy crumbles.
Right, he is no longer in range of any of his attacks, so I think we're going to go for the Battle Balance buff. Delightful. Right, how many hit points has he got left? Ooh la la, that's pretty saucy. 4 damage for rounds. It's not going to kill him. Now, what to do? To heal or go for a potentially catastrophic amount of damage on him? You know what, we could pull him forward now. Bring him back into range of our heavy hitters.
Oh, sweet lord, we seem to have been successful.
Na 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 na.
It seems like you're in range of my smite.
Here it comes.
With no
As they say in the trade, Kaboom! Okay, let's see if we can take out these bad boys quickly. Boom. Let's do some psychiatric work while we're here. Tally boys, of course, it's time for you to heal people. 14. Acceptable. 7. Unacceptable. Here it comes. Are you ready? Another heal? Yeah, let's take away the stress. Oh, you can do it on other people. I didn't realise that. I think he can only do it on himself. Oh, man, we can take everyone back totally sane. Look, we're just going to debuff you, right? Ooh, no, I'm not. I'm going to actually do very big damage relative to your health bar size. Good dodging. Okay, what's next? All right, who to... you? Yep. A heal on base on Mars. Oh, come on. What? It's the best I could do for you, base. I'm sorry. Oof. He's down to the danger zone. Very clearly the danger zone. So, what do we do? Go for a purge? Knock back? Clear all corpses? No, I know what to do. Use the bloody bandages. Come on, scoundrel. Pull your head out of your ass. Alright, you hee-haw. You're going down. Don't kill him. Oh, good dodging base. Perfect time. Perfect time to pull a dodge out. He could probably do with a little bit of TLC. To look. You definitely need some healing. That's more like it. 28. Much better than 0, isn't it? I mean, it depends on the context, obviously. 0 is not intrinsically worse than 28. 0 could be just what you need. But, you know, in the health stakes, 0 is definitely a preferable number only in received damage. What am I talking about? I'm going off on a little crazy rant. I'm really taking the piss now. They're going to get some reinforcements. Almost certainly. But I think we can get this sanity really sorted. Let's just chop some corpses. Holy shit, they don't last long. Okay, who to... base? Dropping frames. We are see. Holy shit. 4.6% apparently. Heal or what? Yeah, heal going. Give yourself a little love. Not like that. Not in the dungeon. Wait till we get back. Let's get rid of some more stress from you. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Keep uselessly flailing at our leper. It's going to be fine. Oh, man. He has to attack. He can't not do anything. Is that actually going to... Does that do any damage? Yeah, plenty of damage. Okay, so what have we got? Diseased herb and vengeful greed.
They can be beaten.
Well, I think we'll ditch the bandage, the chauvel, and take the loot. Brilliant! Back to the hamlet. Necromancer dispatched. Okay. Show me the loot. What have we got? 3 grand. Doesn't seem like that much, to be honest, but we did have the torches up high, so... Tally boys, you've reached level 5. Warrior of Light, Spotted Fever. Nighty-night, Orosco, nighty-night. The Yips, bugger. And Sin Gospel got nout, but everyone's doing well. Everyone's doing well.
Stagecoach upgrades are vital to the long-term health of your roster.
Women and men, soldiers and outlaws, fools and corpses. All will find their way to us now that the road is clear.
A day long awaited. Word of our predicament has spread, and a new crop of aspiring corpses step from the stagecoach. 6 more recruits than usual. Oh, look at that. They're all holding hands. Okay, we've got Howville, Mariscott,
Busnoise, Roussel, Woodville, Montague, Cardinal, Belmis, Port, Fausson, Myron, and Maynet. Sorry, I haven't really got any openings at the moment. You're just going to have to come back another time. I mean, I appreciate the turnout, but what can I do? Let's look at the sanity stakes. We could take that same party on another run. You know what? They did well. They did very well. Let's have a quick look at the embark screen and see what's going on. What do we got? We've got another dungeon. We could take them against the Brigand 12-pounder. Actually, it was a smaller cannon last time, wasn't it? Oh, shit. We can't take them all, can we? Tally boys can't go. Tally boys, you're far too high a level. Oh, no. We've got two level 5 healers and bugger all else to do. Well, we could take two healers. The man-at-arms... I mean, he's too crazy at the moment. He can't go right now. But, let's see how the treatments went. He went in. It was, Fuzzy, you went in, didn't you? Oh, I only cured the one. Rubbish! Rubbish! Who else went in? JC, you went in. I think... Did he cure one or two for him? I think it was just the one. Oh well, at least they're less ill. That's the main thing. What have we got in the Weald?
The camouflage cloak.
Hell's hairpin. Moon cloak. Worry stone. Do I go for the bright tambourine? The fortifying garlic? I'm not sure. I know what I will go for, though. A break. That seems like an excellent idea, because I do need to go to the loo, and I fancy a drink. So I'm probably going to go and make myself one quickly. Let me just turn on the webcam. Hello again. Welcome back to my face. As you can see, it hasn't changed much. It's about the same as it's ever been. Well, obviously, it's different from when I was a baby. I didn't have a beard then. Or long hair. But I've had that since I was about 14. So, you know, that's most of my life, right? I haven't changed a lot. Even when I mean, this used to be significantly less dense. It was very bum fluffy, but I still wore it with pride. Anyway, thanks for watching, YouTubers. I'm going to stop the recording now, and when I see you next, who knows what I'll be playing, but if you're following a playlist, I'll probably be playing this. By the way, all of my game runs are in playlists, so if you ever feel like you want to just sit back and watch a load of stuff, stick it on. It's all good. Have it on in the background while you're doing something. Just every now and again look over at the screen and go, oh, yes, it's Darkest Dungeon. I know what that looks like. It'll be great. Or whatever you're watching. Anyway. My t-shirt comes from Bangladesh. Oh my good God. Now we realise the true horror behind the shirts. They must have the tears of Bangladeshi children soaked into the hems. The blood from the pricked fingertips of their women as they put the little stitches in. It's disastrous. But, unfortunately... too late to do anything about now, apart from grieve what we have lost in dignity and honour. Oh, that's enough grieving. What to do now? I'm torn between Darkest Dungeon and Stardew Valley, so we'll have to make that decision in the break. I'm going to make myself maybe even a coffee. Who knows? But we'll see. And I'll be back in a little while. I mean, don't get me wrong, I am, you know, not happy about work conditions for people in the third and developing world. You know, it's not good. It's not good, is it? But, you know, it's how it is. You just got to try not to do it. Unfortunately, I just did it, and I made you all do it as well, which really sort of like focuses the blame on me, yeah. It's made me seem a very poor sort. But luckily, I am pretty much a bit of a wrong'un. So, it's not that bad, is it? In the grand scheme of things. Not that I've done anything that bad. I've never forced anyone to labour for very poor subsistence wages. That's not in my nature. Anyway, enough. Let's go for the break, shall we? And afterwards, we'll either be playing Stardew Valley or Darkest Dungeon. Comment in chat as you feel appropriate. And of course, I'll still be holding my phone. I'll log in. Watch this. I'm going to log into the Twitch app.
Here we go. And as I walk away from the computer, I'll still be able to deal, at least with those of you watching on Twitch, those of you on YouTube or any other platform. Conan? Conan's the second most popular game at the moment. I had no idea there was a... Is that the MMO? That'd be ridiculous. By the way, Hearthstone, I know no one's going to want to watch me stream it, but if anyone wants to play, I'm Scoundrel M, and I have very few friends. So, you know, I'm not very good at it. You'll beat me. You'll more than likely beat me, but, you know, I'd like to play it. So, yeah, give me a shout. Anyway, what was I looking for? I was looking for my own channel, and if I can't find that, then God help us all. There we go. It's a new survival sandbox that released today. Straight up nudity. You know, personally, I'm not that fussed by nudity, but it depends on how it's presented, really, doesn't it? I mean, there's nudity in the tasteful
oh
kind of way, and there's nudity in the kind of way, which, you know, clearly one has a slightly less acceptable appearance than the other. Certainly on Twitch. I mean, both have their place, of course, but that place for one of them is not here. Anyway, I am going to disappear for this break, and I'll be back in a little while. I'm not going to put a time frame on it, but if I had to guess, which is actually doing exactly what I just said I wouldn't, but nevertheless I'm doing it, I'd say 10, maybe 15 minutes. I'm going to try and keep it to 10, though. I'll be back in a little while. And, yeah, start going on about the old what to play next. And also, I'm still going to keep playing Darkest Dungeon, but I'm getting a little tired of just Darkest Dungeon, Stardew Valley, Darkest Dungeon, Stardew Valley. I'm looking around maybe to see if I've got another game to pick up, because now I've got like 500 odd quid to spend on the new computer when it becomes necessary. I just got another lot of money from Amazon, and I thought, I could invest in a game, like no more than 20 quid, but I could invest in a game. Maybe RimWorld, but we played that before, we'll see. Anyway, I'm babbling. I'll see you in a little while. And I've just remembered the link that I always forget to post. Here we go. My Steam group. If you're not already a member and you're enjoying this, join the Steam group, because you get notified every time I start through Steam. So even if you're playing a game and not really watching your phone, pop, there you go, there's a little notification, which may annoy you. I mean, there is that. But they only happen on like 2 days a week, which at the moment, which ones they are is kind of up in the air. But, you know, it's not that intrusive, is it? Anyway, thank you for watching up till now, and I will see you when I get back. Bye. There we go.
Nobody cares a damn where you come from or who you are. These are carriage horses from London.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you.
Oh, the music ran out. That's the worst possible thing. Good job I was sitting here and I heard it run out. But it's run out a little while ago, didn't it?
It hasn't run out, it's just I can't hear it through the headphones when they're not in.
Oh, disaster. All the illusion of professionalism shattered with one tiny error. What a bomberino. Right, let's get my phone back on the charge. And we can reduce the volume on this music because it's getting a bit out of hand, isn't it? It's a little bit loud. I've decided that I agree with the Singor's analysis of the situation. Oh, that was a bit jarring, wasn't it? And we're going to play Stardew Valley. There you go. Stardew Valley, and then you see what I do here? I get Darkest Dungeon Beards. Highlight Darkest Dungeon. And I type in Farm Beards, and then we save. And now we're in the right category. Isn't that a splendid thing? Isn't that a wonderful thing? Let's quickly load up Stardew. Press S. Secret of Monkey Island. Well, we could play the Monkey Island games. I forgot about them. I still haven't gone through them. I might do that. Let's get rid of that, because that's in the way, honestly. Where are we? Stardew Valley. There we go. Who needs professionalism? Well, I presume people who do this professionally, but wow, that doesn't seem like a doesn't seem like something to aim for. It seems like something to graciously accept if it happens. I think if you aim for it, you're setting yourself up for disappointment. All right, where are we? We're on the wrong screen, aren't we? Let's quickly let everybody know what we're playing. Yeah, that's right, Stardew Valley. Ah, but you knew that because you just heard me tell you. Let's go over to the actual game. Oh, look at that. Good old concern date. Well done, sir. Well done. You have done a good one. Right, where are we? Never seen a flamingo in the game. If that is what they are. Okay, let's get the load screen up and start recording for YouTube. Here it comes. Oh, I'm already recording. Oh, I didn't stop recording at the end of the last video. Shit. Let's stop recording again.